I built this ukulele in 2013, and I made an hour-long series on how to build it, which you probably haven't seen because not many people watched it because it was just way too long. So I took all those videos and edited the whole build down to 17 minutes. I'm going to make the sides of the ukulele out of this piece of white oak, and I'm cutting that into thin strips on the table saw. And then using a high quality blade to shave off just a little bit off of each side, just to make it a bit smoother. And then doing some final smoothing using a cabinet scraper. I rigged up this steamer on my rice cooker. It's just a piece of ABS pipe wrapped in paper towel to keep it warm. After steaming the wood for about 10 minutes, I clamp it to my bending form. The bending form isn't actually the shape of the ukulele. It's actually a little bit overbent to compensate for spring back. So I wanted to create a bending form that once the strip is unclamped, it'll come out to roughly this shape. So I want the bending form to be about 20% tighter than the final shape. So I took the shape and approximated it as a series of circular arcs. And then I took each of these arcs and made the radius 20% tighter and drew a shape like this in the CAD program, and that was pretty tricky. And so I've got this shape here that hopefully once it relaxes will be closer to this shape here. So let's see how this matches. So I made the neck and tail blocks, and I made the neck block a little bit thicker because the neck has to attach to that. It has to take the weight of the strings. And I used my belt sander to round that to match what I've got so far. I need to widen the edges of the sides so that I have more glue surface for the front and back to glue on. And for that, I'm using some bent strips of wood and just gluing it on. So I'm sanding the lining flush with the edges so that I can glue the front and the back on top of here. This very fine-grained piece of construction lumber is going to make my soundboard. And I'm resawing that on the bandsaw into thin slices. I glued two of those pieces edge to edge to get a piece wide enough for the ukulele. Then trimming it close to final width on the table saw as best as I can. So I leveled the middle with a hand plane, and now I'm using my finest sandpaper to really smooth that out. Now using my one-to-one printout to figure out how the soundboard is going to line up with the body. These are the ribs for reinforcing the soundboard. I'm carving these down a little bit just to cut down on weight, which should brighten the sound a bit. Now cutting out the back of the ukulele out of white oak, very similar to how I made the soundboard, but it's heavier and thicker. I'm using my long reach C clamps to make sure that the edges are aligned as I glue the two halves together. No festool dominoes here. And also adding some ribs to the back, though these are not nearly as critical as the ones for the soundboard. So next I need to make the neck for this ukulele. And that neck is joined with a scarf joint, which is kinda tricky to cut on the table saw. So here's the neck, and this is gonna make part of the block here. I still need to cut that out here. And then this goes on here. That packing tape prevented the glue from sticking where I didn't want it to. So next I want to taper this neck just a little bit, and I'll do that on the table saw. And a bit more hand shaping using a spoke shave. And then smoothing it a bit on the belt sander. So what I want to do is create a flat spot on here for where I'm going to attach the neck. So next I need to cut the neck mortise in the ukulele. And a really good tool for that is the panto router. So now I have on here a tenon template for cutting the tenon in the end of the neck. So I've now very carefully positioned the neck. Good fit. Now transferring the mounting hole locations to the neck by whacking a drill bit in there. I cut a notch in an anchor bolt so I could use it sort of like a tap to pre-thread those holes to avoid splitting the wood. And so now from this side, I just put on the nuts. Of course, once the back is on, I have to insert these nuts through the sound holes, so just making sure that that's possible. So having roughly finished the neck, next I need to make a fretboard. And I'm just painting a piece of maple black because I don't have any ebony. And a coat of varnish on top of the paint. And then working out where the frets go. There are, of course, fret spacing calculators online, but it's pretty easy to calculate on a calculator just by taking the scale length and keep dividing it by the 12th root of 2, and that gives you the position of every fret. I'm cutting the fret slots using my Japanese Dozuki saw and a block of wood to help guide it. I have a strip of wood on either side of the fretboard, and once the saw starts cutting into that strip of wood, I know I've cut deep enough. I've been fretting over a good way to get these little thingamajigs to stick into their slots. These things have a little tang on them, and it's very difficult to actually try to stand them up there and push them over without the whole thing just kind of tipping over. I hold it on here on the end and just start pressing that in from the end. So now moving over to the vise, I use a block of wood. And I'll just squeeze that starting from one end and working my way towards the other end.
And it makes sure the whole fret just goes in there straight. So I want to make sure I have all of these perfectly level so that I don't have to rework these very much. I'm going to cover the edges with black so that it looks like it was all one dark material. The posts on these are a bit too short, especially once I put this around here. So I've got the neck in here, and I've got my router, and I just put two parallel rails so that I can then carve out a cavity. That's good. Put these a tiny bit too close together, and so I had to grind them flat, like right here, to make them not bump up against each other. And now I'm just sanding this a little bit to make sure all the frets are level. Time to flush trim these edges, and I'm actually going to use a 1/4 inch roundover bit mostly sunken into the table. Traditionally, the strings of a ukulele or a guitar are anchored to the bridge, but that means the bridge needs to be fairly heavy to take all that load, and that might muffle the sound. So what inspired me to experiment is this cheap guitar. We've got this metal thing here, and that anchors the strings, and the bridge itself is actually just this little thing in here, and it's not even mounted on there, so you could still move it. So I added an extra block here to put some screws into for anchoring the strings in. So I just want to check that things are fairly straight. I've got it adjusted so that this comes fairly centered, and I will center where my strings anchor right between here. I put some screws in here and I made a very light bridge on the belt sander, and I've made a nut also mostly with a belt sander and a file. I'm just going to test some strings on here. And now I finally have enough confidence in this ukulele to glue on the back. It's interesting, you can hear where the braces are. So here it sounds more muffled, and this is on the brace. This is a third coat I'm putting on here. I put two coats in there already before I sanded the frets, just so that I wouldn't end up getting the rest of this dirty. This is not going to make the kind of finish that you'd see on a really expensive guitar. I'm adding one more coat of varnish right over the frets because it's easy enough to scrape off the metal afterwards. So getting a smooth finish takes a lot of meticulous work, which is why I suck at it. I've been scraping away imperfections in the varnish after every coat, but I'm about to put on the fifth coat, which might be the final coat, so I have to be more careful applying it this time. The general advice for varnish is to put on many thin coats, but I like to put on a really thick final coat so that kind of surface tension hopefully pulls it smooth and it'll be a glossy surface. Well, this finish wouldn't be up to Pat Hawley's standards. Now the last string on here.
I'm putting a cutoff nail behind the nut, and that keeps it from sliding side to side.
So I've been experimenting with different bridge designs. I made this one out of spruce to be really light, like the soundboard, but Pat says a bridge should be really, really hard. So now I'm making another bridge out of maple similar to this one. I cut that wood triangular just by passing it behind the saw blade,
like this.
And next I want to cut a bit of an arch in here, something like this, so that the bridge thins towards the edges. I'm using a file to make the notches for the strings. This is a triangular profile file. I painted this bridge black just because I figured that would look nicer balancing against the black fretboard. So if you read what some guitar builders have posted about some of my methods, you kind of expect it to sound something like this. But it's actually not that bad. So 6 years after I built it, it still hasn't exploded or anything, and I still don't know how to play it.